I was warm by the comfort of my home. I could be my true self. I was free. Free to jump on anything. Free to scream as loud as I wanted. Free to cry as long as I needed.
No, no. Don't turn off the camera.
Why not?
Because I want you to turn it on.
The floors became lava. There was a powerful freedom in that house. A freedom that reminded me of a world with no pain, no worry, and no rules. In the back of my parents' car, I learned so much about the world. When I looked outside, the buildings pierced the sky. The roads twisted and turned and dipped and rose. It was like a roller coaster. And then I began turning complete strangers into friends. Each time hoping to create a bond that would last forever. I secretly made them a promise. That I would never forget them. School was an entirely new world for me. But I quickly turned this unfamiliar place into my own personal playground. It was where I learned who I truly was. It was where I could release my inner excitement about the world. It was where the back of the bus became invitation-only parties. It was where the lame school dances turned out to be the highlight of our year. I was in love with my world. But then I opened my eyes a little wider and saw something different.
And outside
there, two officers embracing after a campus filled with fear that it was happening again. In the end, the gunman shot an officer dead, and it's believed he then turned the gun
on
himself.
Good morning, America. Breaking news, deadly church shooting. Tragedy in Charleston.
The investigation into the high school massacre is slow-moving and dangerous. The two gunmen who went on the rampage...
...revealing the worsening toll, at least 59 now dead, more than 500 injured. What they've now discovered in the suspect's Nevada...
Trayvon Martin, an unarmed black teenager, was shot down by a white neighborhood watchman who claimed self-defense.
I saw a world on fire. One where blood ran down the streets I used to play on. One where men and women were separated by simple difference. Hallways I used to walk became more like dirty prison walls. I got too close to the flame.
The number of cases of COVID-19 outside China has increased 13-fold.
Now concerns about the deadly coronavirus officially hitting the U.S. Here's what we
more than 2,000 deaths were reported on Friday alone.
The more than 126,000 people hospitalized nationwide.
Now to another grim milestone, the world surpassing 1 million deaths from the coronavirus.
COVID-19 deaths have passed the 3 million mark.
And then I got burned. Everyone. wanted to believe it was all a nightmare, but I couldn't lie to myself. So instead, I stood up and wiped the tears from my face. I was in so much pain. But I guess that's how the world works. Painful. And that's okay. Because there's something that pain couldn't stop me from doing. Seeing beauty. We spent the better half of our lives loving the world. And we spend the rest learning to hate it. But the world still belongs to us. So we choose what to do with it. Love it or hate it, we're here. For a reason to stay. Reasons like finding love. Like making history.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
I have a dream.
Like living for those who can't. Life can suck, but look up. And you realize you're not alone.
A lot of ups and downs, more downs than ups. But you know, we all got through it together.
Cheers.
And I just can't wait for the next chapter in our lives.
Oh, that's perfect. That's actually perfect, Serge. That's actually perfect.